So the project's called Acres and Acres. It's a co-op that we formed after the bushfires and during the start of COVID, as a response to the food shortage that we had, but then the food shortage that could have come from COVID if things didn't go so well. As everyone knows, that community gardens have been a big part of recovery, and this is no different. It's people talking from all different walks of life about their experiences and what's been going on. So it's got many different levels of how it works, and it produces the most beautiful, fresh, organic food as well for the community, of which we don't really have that source currently. And many regional communities actually don't, which is kind of something that people don't usually think about.
This is our community tour library. It holds all the tools necessary to put in a 1 to 2 acre size market garden in a few days. We've got paper pot planter, which puts seedlings straight into the ground from a nursery. 6-row seeders, and literally you can do a couple of hundred, say, lettuces or radishes within a few minutes into a 30 metre bed. So the idea is that the tools can be used by anyone in our community to start up their own kitchen gardens, market gardens, building resilience around food, and allowing opportunity of fresh produce to be purchased and sold inside of our community, local growing economy. We hope that it helps inspire a new industry within our area, and that the model could be taken and used in other areas once we figure out what we're doing. The trailer itself can also convert into a market formation, which you see on the other side, and that allows us to sell produce. And when it's not in that market formation, the other side is actually a mobile nursery and can grow enough seedlings to put in an acre, so in that one little side.
One of the projects we will do is, if there's another disaster close by, and this is such a big region, we can take this, the composting truck, we could go to a site and plant out an acre size garden in a couple of days with the machinery we've got. It's not agricultural big scale, it's all like hand driven, but we can plant out, 500 lettuces for say. You've still got human participation, which is the important part for us, because we've still got that community that's built around farming and not so much one person running 10,000 acres. This actually has 10 people to run the project, but still can run by itself, can still profit. So it's a social enterprise at heart that can fund itself, hopefully, in the next couple of years.